In this video tutorial, we're going to consider these two sentences. There is a chair in the room, and the chair is in the room. These two English sentences are very, very similar, and they're probably going to give learners of English quite a lot of trouble. But there are two very similar sentences in Japanese, which we're going to look at in this video tutorial and see if we can see the difference between the two. The first one, there is a chair in the room. Now the key word here is actually a, because when we put a in front of a chair, it means we're talking about any old chair. It's not a chair that we who are talking are aware of in any way. It's a random chair that we don't know about. In other words, it's new information. And new information in a sentence is generally where the focus of the sentence is. So this sentence, there is a chair in the room, is probably in answer to a question such as, what is there in the room? Is there anything there that we can sit on? What is there in the room? And the answer is, well, yes, there's a chair in the room. So the chair here is the key information in the sentence. Now, to make this sentence work in Japanese, we're going to have to change the order of the words, and then we're going to have to find equivalents for them. So let's first of all start with the verb. It's is, and actually it's part of a combined expression, there is. So in fact, this is the verb here, there is, and in a Japanese sentence, it will have to go at the end. So let's change it round and put it at the end. Okay, now there is at the end of the Japanese sentence where it goes. Now we're going to move backwards from our verb, and in a Japanese sentence, the most important information is at the end, and the least important information is down here at the beginning. Now the verb is considered the most important part of the sentence, so it goes right at the end. But in front of that is the information which we would consider new information or focus information. And we've already discussed that it's actually the chair here that's the focus of the sentence. That's the new information we're talking about. So we're going to take the chair and we're going to pop it just in front of the verb. Okay, now we've got a chair, there is. That's much more Japanese. Finally, we've got the location in the room. Now this is not key information, so it's going to go at the front of our sentence. So we've now changed our sentence to reflect the Japanese word order. In the room, a chair, there is. Now we're going to replace each one of these with the equivalent Japanese word. And then we're going to find out which particle we need to follow each one. First of all, in the room. Now in the room consists of the room and then this word in. Now again in Japanese, the preposition, or in Japanese we call it the particle, is going to follow the relevant word. So we've got to change the order of this expression as well. And we've got to make it the room in. So the room in, a chair, there is. Let's find the word for the room. We don't have to include the, simply saying room is fine. So we're going to grab the word for room and we're going to bring it down and we're going to substitute it for the room. So there we have here, and we can get rid of the room. Now we've got the location particle in. Now there are two location particles in Japanese. One is de, and that's used with action verbs. And the other one is ni, and that one's used specifically with arimasu and imasu. Now this verb ends in there is, which is actually arimasu in Japanese. So we now know that we need to substitute in with our location particle ni, and in fact we can find it right down here. So we're going to take ni and we're going to exchange that for in. Now we have here, ni, in the room. Next we're going to put our chair, that's new information, and that's got to go close to the verb at the end for emphasis. Here's the word for chair, isu. And we're going to bring that down here and substitute it for the English chair. So far so good. Here, ni, in the room, isu. Now our sentence is going to be a little longer than this, so let's just shift those words across. So here, ni, in the room, isu. Okay, now before we consider the particle that we need, let's just substitute the verb. We've just mentioned that the verb there is down here, arimasu in Japanese. And a better way to actually think of that verb is not there is, but there exists. Because this is a very tricky word to translate into Japanese, because we have just one word is, where the Japanese have two. because one of our ears means something exists, and the other of our ears is similar to Japanese des, which is saying something is the equivalent of something else. It's almost like a maths equal sign. But this one is not des. It's this there exists, which is arimasu. So we're going to pop that up here, arimasu, and we're going to get rid of the English there is. Here ni isu particle arimasu. Now the particle here is very easy because we know that with arimasu, generally in the positive, it takes particle ga. So that's a very good reason for choosing ga. But there's also another reason that we could use to choose ga, and that is because ga focuses attention on the word that stands before it. It tells you this is the important information in the sentence. Whereas if we were to mistakenly choose particle wa does not focus attention on the word that comes before it. Rather, it indicates that this word before it is simply background information, and the exciting part of the sentence is after. Now this arimasu, there is, it's not the new information in the sentence. It's just telling you that the chair exists. It's actually the chair that we want to focus information on, because remember the question would be something like, what is there in the room? In the room, there's a chair. That's key. So it takes particle ga. And there we have it. There is a chair in the room. 部屋に椅子があります。Let's put those words back and consider the next sentence. Okay, we've put 椅子 back on the chair. We've got 部屋 there to indicate that this is a room. And we've got the other things we might need down here. Let's have a look at the second sentence. The chair is in the room. Now in English, when we put the in front of a noun, it tells us that this is something that both the person who is speaking and the person who is being spoken to, that you both understand what chair you're talking about. It's a chair that you've discussed before. It's a chair that you know about. So it's not new information. It's background information. And in fact, the key information in this sentence is not that there's a chair, but the fact that that chair is in the room. So the question for this one might be, where is the chair? And the answer would be, the chair is in the room. And it's this part of the sentence that is key. So the chair becomes background information. Background information goes at the beginning of our Japanese sentence. The verb goes at the end of our Japanese sentence. And any other important information goes just before the verb. So let's start with putting the verb, the chair is. Now, although up here we've got there is, and here we've only got is, they both mean exists. So it's the equivalent of the chair exists in the room, and it's that same Japanese verb arimasu. So let's take our other arimasu and pop it there at the end of the sentence. Now in front of arimasu is going to go the key information, and in this case the key information is where the chair is, and that's the room. So we're going to get the room and we're going to pop it down here. Now that's still our location, so it needs a location particle. And it needs the location particle, which specifically goes with arimasu and imasu. And that's this one here, ni. So we're just going to take that ni and we're going to pop it after here to indicate that that is our location. So in the room. It exists in the room. Now, just so as we emphasize that it's actually the chair that is in the room, even though because it's the, we already know which chair we're probably talking about, we need to pop the chair in at the beginning as our background information. And because it's background information, it will not be taking particle ga, because that would throw emphasis on the chair. Now chair in this case, isu, is background information, and background information would not take particle ga. If we were to pop particle ga there, the focus immediately would be on isu, and in fact our focus here is on the room, not the chair. So we're going to remove particle ga, and instead we're going to choose topic particle wa, because that throws the focus of the sentence on the new information, which is following particle wa. And it tells us this is simply background. So as for the chair, the one that we've been talking about all this time, in the room, it exists. It is in the room. Let's have a look at those sentences one more time. There is a chair in the room. The chair is in the room. In the room, in the case of the English sentences, stays the same. And so it does in Japanese. 部屋に部屋に. But in the top sentence, in the room is background information, so it goes at the beginning of the sentence. Whereas in this sentence, it's the key new information, so it's got to go closest to the verb at the end. The chair, on the other hand, is not the same. In the top one, it's got particle ga following, and in the bottom one, it's got particle wa. And indeed, the English sentence, also the chair is different. In the top one, it's a chair, and in the bottom one, it's the chair. So the chair that we already know about, that we both understand, is isu wa. Whereas a chair, that's a chair that's new to both of us, that takes particle ga. That throws the emphasis on it, so isu ga. Hopefully that's made it easier for you to understand the difference between those two sentences, both in English and in Japanese.